All right, in this one we are gonna see what GitLab CI/CD variables are. And simply put, it's a way to just have environment variables in your jobs that can be either hard-coded or set in the GUI here, in the web interface, or inherited from the group, or can be also dynamically generated from previous jobs. Anyway, we are gonna see all that here. So again, once again, I have an empty repository, which I've cloned. And as always, we're gonna create a GitLab CI.yaml file in which I'm gonna have one stage, which is gonna be, whoops, which is gonna be print variables. And I'm gonna have just those jobs. So again, the image is the default image. And that's how you declare variables for the whole pipeline. So you just have a variables keyword. And here you just list a bunch of environment variables that you want in your jobs. And you can list as many as you want, like so. But so those are global to the pipeline, so available for every single job. And here in the job itself, you can also declare variables that are local to the job. So the variables here won't be available in a later job. And here I have forgotten to print other var. So let me commit and push this and see the result. All right, it's done. And as you can see, the basic print job displayed the pipeline variable and the other variable that was local to the job. And the override print, which I wanted to show that if you have a global variable, but then you have the local variable with the same name, it will override the global variable. So here you can see that some var was overwritten. So that's simple enough, but that's still just hard-coded values that you can. That's a way to just organize your pipeline to have the stuff you want to change from time to time here, maybe a URL or something, to make it a bit clearer instead of hard-coding it in the script every time. Next, we're gonna see that there is actually predefined. Let me remove all this. There is already predefined variables set by just GitLab itself. And so for example, you can see that there is a CI variable that's very useful if you have a script and you want to have a different behavior when you're in CI/CD instead of when you're running it on your local machine, for example. You can have the commit author, the commit SHA, if there is a tag on the commit, you can get that as well. You can get the commit branch, message, you can get the project name. You can get the project ID also if you want to do some meta stuff and query the GitLab API and do some meta stuff on your repository. So let's see how it works. All right, it's done. Let's see what the output is. And as you can see, the CI will just be true. And so if you're not in CI/CD, it should be just empty. That's how you can check. The commit author is me, commit SHA. Tag, since this commit doesn't have a tag, there is nothing. The branch is master. We can get the message and the project name as well. So yeah, that's pretty handy to, especially if you want to run a job only on one particular branch or only on commits that are tagged with rules. We will see that later. So next we have, you can also create dynamic variables. Oh no, next we have like how you can set variables in the GUI. So on your if you go into your repository settings and you go into CI/CD here, you see you have a variables section, which if you expand, you can set variables. And so you just do add variable, and then you can set a key, which will be the environment variable name, and you can set a value. And you can also protect that variable. That means that if you have like protected branch, like your main branch is protected, but then all the feature branches are unprotected. This means that this variable will only be available to the protected branch. This is useful if you have like a deployment token or something like that. That you don't want like any random dude to be able to have access to. You can also make it visible if it's just, I don't know, a username or a URL, but you can also mask it. For example, again, if it's a token or a password, you want to mask it, of course. And so, yeah, here I have created two variables, one username and one password. And you can also create those CI/CD variables in the group itself. And so here you have a GitLab group that has multiple repositories. And if you go again, same thing, settings, CI/CD, and variables, same process, you can create variables, but those variables will be available for every single repository in that group. So this is quite handy if you have like a common Docker registry, for example, for every single of your repository. So yeah, let's see that in action. Okay, seems to be done. Let's see how it looks. So the username, that was the repository variable, just a plain text is Cachar, my name. But then the password that I set as masked, you can see that there is an actual value for it, but it will replace every instance of it by this. So the bigger masked. And of course, the group variable I defined is also present. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Let's now do for the last part, let's see how we can create dynamic variables. So this is a bit more tricky and there is some concepts that we haven't seen yet, but I will still show it because it's quite handy. And so I need a new stage. So here we have a create and file. So the goal of this is that to have one job that will dynamically declare environment variables to configure the jobs that come after it. So for example, in my previous job, we used to use this to we had like a JavaScript package that has a package.json with a version number in it, and you wanted to extract that version number into an environment variable so that you can upload a Docker container with the correct tag, for example. So here I have a create and file job that has a script that will, and what you do is you just extract whatever value your environment variable has, and then you just echo it, you can just push it into some file. In my case, it's a .env file. And what you do is you create an artifact and then reports.env. Again, don't worry too much about what this does, but we haven't seen that yet, what the reports are. But what you need to understand is just that the .env will take every single line of this file and will upload them to the next job as environment variables. And so here you can see in the job after that, we just reuse all the variables we have declared. So foo, another one, and it will work. Let's see how it looks. Okay, it's done. So you can see that we have the create env file that created a .env file with all those variables. And then if we go in the next stage, so print variables with the print env file job, we can see that all those variables, even though we haven't declared them like in the GitLab CI.yaml file directly, are all declared here as per the previous job. So that's quite handy if you want dynamically declared variables. Anyway, that's all I've got for variables, and yeah, hope you enjoyed it and see you.